Sister Mary Jane. Praise the Lord. Thank God for our children. Thank God for every person that's here today. Appreciate Brother George and Brother Larry going to come support me here behind the pulpit. It's always good to have somebody, a voice behind you, pressing you forward. Hallelujah. I need a little shout every once in a while, but guys, yeah, come on. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I'll take it out there, too. Amen. Amen. I'm really excited today. I'm excited today about Jesus and about we're seeing through this week. We saw four different people before today receive Jesus. I'm expecting mighty things, whether it be on our telecast, whether it be on a worldwide network, whether it be on YouTube, or whether it be here in the sanctuary, somebody else to be saved today. Listen, yeah, the Bible, Jesus said, believe me. He just said, believe me. And I want to talk about that. Just believe Jesus. I mean, you know, there's so many people trying to pressure us to believe so many different things of what do's and don'ts, cans and can'ts, what's and whatnots. Jesus just said, why don't you just believe me for a change? Why don't the churches throw out all the garbage and all the doctrine and all the knowledge and just believe Jesus? Why don't we just quit doing all this division and I believe it? Why don't we just stop and believe Jesus? Why don't preachers and teachers and churches just stop all the junk and just believe Jesus for a change? Do you know that straightened everything out? That straightened out the religious community. There are hundreds of different divided denominations that says we believe this. And I won't go to your church because y'all shout or y'all speak in tongues. Another church says I won't go there because they don't shout or don't speak in tongues. And I won't go to your church because you play that music and people want to dance too. And I don't believe dancing is okay in a church where you ain't read about David. There ain't no dancing in the church is dead. Come on, somebody. There will be some dancing in every church in all over the United States and all of there will be people dancing everywhere. Praise God. If you ain't a dancer, hang around a while. God will put a spring in your step through salvation. Jesus said this in St. John chapter 14 and verse 11. Believe me. Say that with me. Believe me. Just believe. I am in the Father and the Father in me, or else believe me for the very works. How many seen God do something? Save or deliver or heal? Or how many seen God remove Satan from people's lives or restore somebody financially or raise up somebody from the dead? How many seen God fix a situation, save a marriage, rescue a child? How many seen God do something? Jesus said, if you don't believe me, just look at what I've done. Hallelujah. Look over at your neighbor. And you do this and they'll make a believer out of you. Come on, somebody. And some of y'all that knew me before I got saved, you say, oh my God, I believe Jesus today. When they see Mark Deason, I can look at some of y'all that I knew before you got saved, and say, wow, whoo, God's real. Come on, somebody. That's how we know that he's real. Not just because the word says, but because the works of God are going on today. He said, believe me. If you don't believe that, just believe what I'm doing. Verily I say unto you, he says, he that believeth on me, of the works that I do shall he do also. In other words, Jesus said, if I can save, I'll lead you to people and you'll lead them to me. He said, if I can heal, I'll touch your hands. You can heal bodies. If I can cast out devils, I'll empower you to cast out devils. If I speak to my Father, which is in heaven, he said, you can speak to him too. Come on, somebody. He said, the same thing I've done is the same thing you're going to do. Hallelujah. Just before Jesus gave this great commandment, this great word, he said before he ascended to heaven, and this was just a few short weeks before he ascended to heaven, he was trying to prepare the disciples that were with him, those that would stand by him, not those that would flee at the drop of a hat, or those that would get disgruntled, or those that would stand in the face of adversity. He said, you're going to do what I did. He said, but listen to this. He said, greater works than these shall. You're going to do bigger things than I did. He said, because I'm, he said, you're going to do because I go to my Father. Raise a hand toward heaven, what we believe. By faith we believe. I believe in you, and I believe what you've done. But I don't just believe what you've done, I believe what you're doing right now. I don't just believe what you're doing right now, I believe the prophetic, what you say you're going to do in the future. And God, I believe in eternity that you're preparing a place for your people. You said, let not your heart be troubled. And God, I'm not troubled today. I'm excited about my future in Jesus. Come on, somebody raise a hand and say, amen, Jesus. Y'all be seated. Just before Jesus, that Jesus passed on and Jesus was crucified. And Jesus, Brother James and I happened to have the honor of going and talking to some young people over the weekend. And it was just a beautiful thing. And we ran into this young man that didn't really know anything about Jesus. He said, that's impossible today. No, it's not. No, it's not. You get people raise their children in lives to completely separate from Jesus. And they know very little other than the fringes and the edges. And so I just got open door of opportunity for us to tell them about Jesus. You know where I began? Genesis chapter 1. I didn't start and try and run it to the cross. You've got to tell people that God is more. He brought forth a life. And the first thing I said in the Bible, God said, in the beginning, God created heaven and the earth. In Genesis chapter 1, verse 3 said, and God said, let there be Jesus. Jesus. Because Jesus said, I am the. The first thing God did was he spoke Jesus into the earth. He spoke the power of God into the earth. Listen, he don't creep. Come on. Said, and that guy looked at me like I was like some of y'all looked when y'all said light. And I said, Jesus. That ain't what my translation. Well, you ain't read what Jesus said. He said, I am the light. So the very first thing God said was, let there be Jesus. And you know what Jesus said? Those two words bring a place. Believe me. Just believe me. That's the first thing. It's the only way you can start. And that's the only way you're going to finish. Preachers try to explain or talk away this scripture that we're talking about today. And that Sunday school teachers really avoid teaching about it a lot. Because no religious doctrine or denomination challenges their people to do what Jesus did. God heals sick folks. When's the last time you did a church? I'm expecting everybody here to go out and heal somebody this week. You ain't going to hear it because most preachers and most churches don't participate in it. They said, well, we got doctors that, yeah, I do. His name is Jesus. Yeah. Believe me. Yeah. Believe me. You don't hear many preachers say, well, I'm expecting everybody in the congregation to go out and find them one devil and whoop that thing and throw it out. Yeah. Come on, you don't hear that? Because you know why? Because people, well, no, we have Jehovah Middle Hells. Jehovah Middle Hells can't help with the devil. It takes believe Jesus. Come on, somebody. Well, glory to God. You can just go on and on about how the church has rejected the doctrine and the truth of Jesus. Denominations have ever separated themselves and churches remotely ever charged their people to do what Jesus did. How many want to do what Jesus did? Woo! Man! How would you like to lay hands on somebody sick? See them dancing in church the next week. Glory to God! How would you like to see somebody, their life estranged with Satan and broken and hurting, and in just a few minutes later they got this smile of peace on their life? We saw it this weekend. Listen to me. God said, believe me. Just believe. Jesus, our Lord, put his total authority as Lord and Savior King behind this statement. Right there. Believe me. Everything. His total authority. Everything that he is on him. Believe me. Come on, listen, neighbor. Say, you got to believe Jesus. Please help me today. Jesus said this in St. John chapter 14, verse 12. Verily I say unto you, verily I say unto you, verily I say unto you, he that go to church. It didn't say that. Verily I say to you, he that buys himself a leather-bound King James authorized verse of the Bible. Don't say that. Because people go to hell with a pretty Bible. They're going to go to hell being a church member. They're going to go to hell with 5 baptism certificates. Been baptized in every church in the community. You ever go to church, I won't be baptized. You ever preach it undipped them. Come on, somebody. But they ain't been baptized by the Master. He said, you shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost. John said, I baptize you with water under repentance. He said, but there's one coming after me. Come on, Brent, could you back up? Could you back up? He said, believe me. There's one coming. You got to believe on Jesus. He said, he will baptize you with the fire from heaven. He said, verily I say unto you, he that believeth on me. Verily I say, he that finds a good study group. No. It didn't say it's he that believes. See, study groups, church, preachers, buildings are no good without Jesus. Amen. It's just a thing you go through. We need Jesus. I need Jesus more than I ever need in my life. Ever, more than ever. And I know all around the world, all around society, everybody's talking about El Paso, Texas, and Dayton, Ohio. Everybody's talking. It's a sad thing. But Jesus, he didn't predict it. He prophesied it. It's in the Bible. There would be killers like you had never seen. See, everybody's just all up there. But let me tell you something. Jesus said, it's all there. It's all there. It's all there. And we was talking about it in South Africa. Everybody in the world's talking about it. But let me tell you, if people would believe Jesus, they would. That 20-year-old boy that shot all them people up, maybe he'd be saved today. Instead of being in jail for killing 20 people and shooting 26. Ain't that awful? Because you know why? Because he evidently he don't know Jesus. Come on, somebody. Because Jesus didn't come to kill, steal, and destroy. He knows the one that kills, steal, and destroy. He knows the one that kills. Jesus says, I come to give you life. Jesus said, I come to let people live. I come to bless people. I come to save people. I come to give them eternity. I come to bless their families. I come to raise up a generation that will worship me. But this boy went out and killed, because you know why? Because he is full. I'm just going to say it. I don't care if it's correct. He is full of the devil. The only the devil kills, and say he stole 20 families of their life.